Paris, my old friend, it's good to see your face again. More welcome though yon trap and that old mare. You see the wife is in a swoon and I am all alone. Paris, fetch thy mare and take us home. The wife and I came out for a quiet glass of stout and a word or two with neighbors in the room. Young Clary, he came in as drunk and wild as sin and swore the wife would leave the place with him. But the wife, as quick as thought, she said, no, I bloody not, and struck the brute a blow about the head. He raised his ugly paw and he lashed her on the jaw. She fell onto the floor where she was dead. Now, Harris, well, you know, I've never struck an angry blow, nor would I keep a friend who raised his hand. I was a conchy in the war, crying, what the hell's this for? But I had to see his blood to be a man. Grabbed him by his coat, spun him round and took his throat, and beat his head upon the parlor door. He dragged out an awful knife and he roared, I'll have your life. Then he struck me and I fell onto the floor. Now, blood I was from neck to thigh, bloody murder in his eyes, as he shouted out, I'll finish you for sure. But as the knife came down, I lashed out from the ground. The knife was in his breast when he rolled over. The wife as cold as clay, I've carried her away. No hand was raised to help us through the door, and I brought her half a mile, but I've had the rest a while, and none of them I'll call a friend no more. For when the knife came down, I lay helpless on the ground. No neighbor stayed his hand. I was alone. And by God, I was a man. But now I cannot stand. Please, Harris, fetch thy mare and take us home. Oh, Harris, fetch thy mare and take us out of here. In my 59 years, I've never known. that to call myself a man, for my loved one I must stand. Paris, fetch thy mare.